I think that the majority of Israelis, if they'll really be faced one day with a clear and stark choice between solving the Palestinian problem in an acceptable way or throwing away this really unique chance to achieve real peace now, I think if they ever are conscious of this choice, they will choose peace. I do believe so.
Iconic veteran left-wing journalist, lawmaker, contrarian Uri Avneri passed away on Monday in Tel Aviv at the age of 94. Born Helmut Ostermann in Germany in 1923, he was raised in a well-off German Jewish family, which left for Mandatory Palestine in 1933, following Adolf Hitler's rise to power. Throughout his life, Avneri was a controversial figure in Israel. Not one to sit on the side and watch history happen, he participated in events that shaped the modern state of Israel. In his youth, Uri Avneri joined the nationalist Irgun movement, fighting the British mandatory forces. A few years later, he would leave the organization and turn away from its ideology. During Israel's War of Independence in 1948, he served in a special forces unit where he was gravely wounded. After the war, Avneri purchased a local weekly magazine and quickly turned it into a groundbreaking tabloid, taking on establishment power and corruption. He was often criticized, threatened, and even physically harmed for his trouble. Always a politician, he founded a political party and from 1965 and for three consecutive election cycles served in the Israeli parliament on the extreme left side of the political divide. Ahead of most Israeli politicians, he became one of the first to actively advocate for the establishment of a Palestinian state. In July of 1982, while Israel was engaged in the Lebanon War, Avneri crossed the lines and besieged Beirut to meet with Yasser Arafat, Israel's number one enemy at the time. This was seen as a sign of treason, and he was threatened with criminal proceedings. Even his mother found it hard to accept and wrote him out of her will. Avneri continued to be active in the fight for peace, leading his Gush Shalom peace movement, speaking out and participating in demonstrations. Most recently, in April of 2018, Avneri wrote an opinion article titled Eyeless in Gaza, where he condemned the killing of Palestinian protesters by Israeli military forces. In his last visit to I-24 News, he highlighted the Israeli-Palestinian conflict around one question.
The question is basically simple. Are we ready to give up the occupied territories and have allowed the Palestinians to have a state of their own or not?
In recent years, Avneri admitted he had failed to realize his ideas politically, but never lost hope. Before his death, Avneri asked to be cremated, for his archives to be donated to the National Library, and his money towards peace activism. His wife and ideological partner, Rachel, died in 2011. The couple chose not to have children. On the last page of his memoir, he wrote, "Life goes on, the struggle continues. Tomorrow is a new day." Daniel Campos, I-24 News.